Joe? Come on, Joe, wake up. There's somebody to see you.
Coming back home is not really an ideal arrangement.
We'd say exactly the same if you were our own.
And it'd upset the lodger.
Naturally, we're absolutely delighted that you're fit enough to be discharged.
That's right. It's wonderful that you're well again, but,
as your mother said at the time.
Thank you. the hell were you doing? Do you want to kill yourself?
Don't know when you first look at somebody, do you, what they're going to mean to you? I think I knew right then, I knew this person was going to change my life. It was like being born.
Croydon. They're not my real parents, I was fostered.
And they live in Croydon.
I didn't mind sleeping on the couch.
Sofa,
sorry. I'd have slept in the garage or anywhere. I was still sick.
Ill,
sorry. But anyway, they didn't want me. They gave my old room to the lodger.
Families with pets.
Was I really going to commit suicide?
Yes, you were.
I can't remember now, it's all a blank. I thought I'd ride round and round on the tube all day. That was my plan, so I could sleep. And then I thought, why not just push somebody under a train? That way I'll be put away forever and never have to worry. It'll all be taken care of. But I don't think I could do it, just kill someone. I don't think so. Could you?
Can you drive, by any chance?
Drive, yeah. But not for a long time, though. I might have forgotten.
You'll soon pick it up again. And I think you should grow a beard.
Never had a beard.
All the more reason, then. You need some clean clothes. You stink.
Everything was nicked. You know, I've got no money. I've got clothes and stuff back at home. But I couldn't stand to go back there.
We'll go shopping. Get you some clean knickers. I saved your life. So your life belongs to me now.
All right.
When in Rome, you have to walk down the Via Condotti and look at the shops. That's where the money is. The rich and the powerful. Bugari jewelry family, the Piatelli clothing empire. Some of them were kidnapped more than once.
More than once? Are we buying perfume?
Scent.
Scent, sorry. This is for girls, isn't it?
No, sir, this is Prince Piranesi, for gentlemen. It comes in three sizes.
Yes, all right, I know, thank you.
Spray? Would you like one of these, sir?
Look what it costs. You'd want to snort it up your nose for that money.
Look at this.
Who's Prince Piranesi?
I'll tell you a story, little Joe.
Arrivederci.
Arrivederci.
Settimana prossima.
Buon viaggio.
There once lived a prince who was not, as you'd imagine, a prince to be. Not handsome and youthful, but old and ugly with a bad heart. Still, it didn't matter because he was extraordinarily rich. Head of the Piranesi perfume empire, with shops all over the world. And, of course, in the Via Condotti.
And he was kidnapped?
No, not him, his wife. The princess. She was young and beautiful, the most beautiful woman in the world.
What happened to her?
It was only 5 years ago, but the golden age of kidnapping was already over, even in Italy. They had three homes. One in Paris, an apartment in Rome, and a villa in the Tuscan hills, not far from Florence. She was driving back to Rome when they took her.
And who took her?
Some Calabrian. Calabrians make the best kidnappers, so it's claimed. The Calabrians were father and son. With them was a foreigner. He drove the second kidnap car. The mountain road was quiet that day. Only the slightest breeze to rustle through the olives and the cypresses. I don't know if she suspected anything. She wasn't Italian, so perhaps she didn't.
Oh,
None of them were what you'd call professional kidnappers. They were inexperienced and therefore dangerous. Amateurs are inclined to panic when things go wrong, and kidnappers, when they panic, kill their victims.
She dead?
You better get in here with me. I don't want you creaking on that thing all night, keeping me awake. Well, come on, then. What do you look like? A sort of skinned weasel. A beard will be good for you.
Condition.
Your condition? You're not pregnant, eh?
Stop me freaking. Oh, let me take a
look. You don't need these.
I do.
No, you don't. They're trying to control your mind with this crap. You've finished with all that now. Take them to the lavatory and flush them away.
No. I need them.
No, you don't. Flush them down the bog.
The doctor.
Go on.
Morning, I'm Paul Garnett to see Mr. Absalom.
He's expecting me. I hope.
What exactly would I be expected to do?
Drive my wife whenever she wants to go out. Walk the dogs occasionally, that's all.
I thought there'd be a bit of gardening, general handyman work.
I have people to do all that. Columbo you met at the gate, he does the maintenance. His wife Maria is our housekeeper. And there are others, of course. But all you have to do is look after my wife. Take care of her.
Take care of her?
Touch of agoraphobia. Let me show you around. If you were successful in your application, when could you start?
Well, I'm on a supply contract, so I could leave at half term. That's just a week or so's time.
Why are you giving up teaching?
A number of reasons. I don't like the way education seems to be going. And I want to get out of London, that's the main thing.
No loose ends to tie up?
No, I'm separated. My flat's rented, so there's no problem. Except I have a small daughter. I didn't mention that in the application.
Oh, yes. Well, it can't be helped. It's a good salary, of course, to ensure loyalty. And there's a cottage that goes with the job. I'm sure you'd like to see that.
What if your wife wanted me to drive her in the evenings?
I drive my wife in the evening. She's not a complete recluse.
I don't know why I just didn't tell him the truth, that I couldn't make it as a teacher. That's why I was leaving. I couldn't handle a class of 15-year-olds. They'd terrorise me. Even the girls, one of them slapped me in the face in the playground and I couldn't deal with it. It's a joke, isn't it? But I told him that, he probably wouldn't have given me the job. This wouldn't be happening.
It's a good thing you were at that place.
Yeah, but I wasn't ready to leave, though. It's like my head was full of dirty water where my mind should have been. Dirty, oily water slurping about. Right, but it was like Nev said, there was no choice. They closed a lot of wards and sent us out. They wanted me to go home to Mum and Dad.
God, I'd rather be locked up in the institution.
They gave my old room to the lodger.
Poor bleeding lodger. I won't go back. All the chocolate biscuits you can eat. Only don't do anything emotional, like fart and have periods. Nah, I won't see them again. Or any of my other foster families. I hate the bastards.
Couldn't wait to get rid of me, that's a fact.
You're all right now, aren't you, Joe?
Yeah. Shandor's changed everything. He saved my life. I'd do anything for him.
Well, keep in touch, eh? I'll write to Brian's address, it'll get to me. And watch out for this Shandor bloke, he sounds weird to me. Just don't trust nobody. Do you promise me? Well, say it then, cross my heart.
Cross my heart and hope to die.
Where the hell have you been?
With my sister. Well, she's not really my sister. What are you doing?
I'm moving soon. Tomorrow, probably.
Where?
Up to East Anglia to be nearer.
Nearer what?
I've got to get a car. How can I get hold of the car? Huh? What's up with you?
You're going away.
That's what I said.
What will I do?
Collect your things, what you've got of them. This place is nearly done with. Leave those! They're private.
Where will I go?
Where will you go?
When you've gone.
I don't know. Do you think I should take you with me? You're not very reliable, are you? Coming home at this hour?
Go with you. I'll do anything.
Go out and post this, then. And don't look at the address. All right. My mother. I'm a remittance man, little Joe.
What's that?
Someone their family pays to keep away.
They give you money.
This is the coldest station in East Anglia. Even in summer, it's like the Arctic. I used to come here sometimes when I was up at Cambridge.
Cambridge?
The university.
Passengers on platform 2, please stand clear of platform 8. Stand clear of platform 8 on platform 2.
Norwich Express.
Doesn't it stop here?
No, that's why it's called an express.
It's a great train!
Did that bring something back just then? Something you'd rather forget? Come on.
We're on our way!
Rent a week in advance, then?
Yeah.
It's only the one double bed. Will that be a problem?
No.
I'll show you to the room. Oh. Don't like a lot of strange noises after midnight, if you know what I mean.
This room is my personal little nerve center. All the doors to sensitive areas of the house have electronically operated internal bolts. They can be locked fast at the touch of a button. Do you shoot at all?
Not with anything like those.
Oh, we must get you some lessons. I've been fascinated all my life with guns. This collection has taken years to build. Take a look at this. It's a 1918 Mauser. Exquisite, isn't it? Soft hands, Garnet. Never mind. You look the part. That's what matters.
Well, they'll soon be used to you. This one's called Odin. Now, here, be quiet. Odin, stand still. This one's called Tyr. German, you see.
I thought Odin and Tyr were Norse gods.
Were they? Well, much the same. Ah, there you are. Garnet, let me introduce you. This is my wife. Down! Down, boy! Down! Maria, take the dog. Take them inside.
Not silly. You must think I'm an awful coward.
No.
You used to be quite brave.
They kept her chained up in a tent.
A tent inside a house. She never knew where. At the end of the first week, they cut off her fingernails and sent the parings to the prince with a note saying next time it would be the whole nail.
They'd rip her nails out.
Who knows with these people? I told you they were amateurs. In Italy at this time, everyone was blasé about kidnapping, so the prince never went to the police. Instead, he demanded proof of life.
Proof of life, huh?
They made a tape of her, begging for help.
Ti prego.
That was the usual thing.
Vai come dicono.
Her voice on tape.
What next?
That's enough for now, little Joe.
She must have been terrified. Well, I would have been. Well, anybody would, wouldn't they?
No.
No.
Come on, clear this mess up. Got work to do tomorrow.
Sodding pervert! Get away and stay away!
No! You can't take any book out of the library unless you're a local resident or you work in the area.
Please.
There are reading facilities.
Success.
What?
Come and see. Look, down there, the green Fiat.
How'd you get it?
My mother.
She gave it you? She gave you a car?
I just took it. You got the book. Good.
Yeah, but there's no place called Jared's in here. I've looked and looked. So she don't know you got the car then? She'll be angry, won't she?
She probably knows by now, but she won't do anything. I'm her only son, right? Anyway, I'll change the registration plate. Look.
Atherton Hall.
Read the bottom line.
Now known as Jared's.
It's 30 miles away. Further than I thought, but never mind. We'll go now. You can drive. Slow down. Park over there on the left.
It's not going to be any good him screaming, because that lion's going to eat him anyway.
For all eternity.
Who lives here?
It was in the book. A man called Absalan. Very rich and an expert in personal security. Don't get too close to the gates.
Why?
Do you see the cameras on either side? There'll be a sophisticated security system. You can bet no expense will be spared. Come on. Tomorrow you start your reconnaissance. That means you watch those gates to see who comes and goes, make a note of every car and visitor. But most of all, I want to know if she comes out, driving herself or being driven. And I want you to follow her.
She? Who's she?
Who do you know who marries rich old men and, after what she's been through, craves security?
The princess.
Do I have to go on my own?
Of course you do. It's 7 now, not 5. Off you go. I'll collect you at home time.
Well, I won't know anyone to talk to.
You'll soon make new friends. Go on. I'll have chips for tea.
Road is off to the left.
Yes, thank you.
My mother's bungalow is very near Tavisham.
Sure, I'll find it.
Of course, you grew up around here, didn't you? Are your parents still in the area?
They're both dead.
I'm sorry.
I've got a brother up in Huntingdon.
What does he do?
He's in farming. My family were all farmers. I'm the odd one out. I went to university instead.
So that was unusual.
I was the first in my family to go.
I bet they were very proud of you.
Yes, they were.
Must be hard for you being better educated than your employers.
Going on? What? You've been following me?
No.
You think I'm stupid?
No.
What are you doing here then?
Just
Where exactly were you going?
Newmarket.
Newmarket? It's nowhere near. Get out. Get out, you scum, and don't let me see you again.
Let him see your face.
I couldn't help it. I had my glasses on. I don't think he'd recognise me again.
No, he won't. You're not going to recognise yourself very soon.
Why? Oh, no. I've only just grown it.
You're highly honoured, my friend. This razor belonged to my great-grandfather.
He wouldn't know me again. He hardly saw me.
I'm moving you.
What's he look like, driver?
Stocky, but not fat.
Fit looking.
Maybe he's a bodyguard. And the little girl is fair and very beautiful. So she must be the princess's daughter.
She doesn't have any children. It must belong to one of the servants.
They have servants, you know.
Don't think they make their own beds, do you?
And I like Katie and all of them.
Don't talk to anyone you don't know, will you, Jess?
Who don't I know?
Strangers, people you don't recognise.
I don't. You always tell me that.
Just checking. Now we're living in the country, you might think it's not so important, but it is. It always is.
Think of them all down there. I wonder what they're doing.
Drinking up and going home.
Not in the bar, you fool. Who gives a shit what those peasants do? I was thinking of the people up at Jared's. Why come to the castle, Patrick? And my heart is on my sleeve. But a lady stole it from me on St. Gallo Glass's Eve.
What was that? Gallo something?
Didn't you tell me you were half Irish, little Joe? In ancient Ireland, the gallow glass was the chief's servant.
Is that me then? The gallow glass, is that what I am?
If you like. Tomorrow we move closer.
Oh. Oh, you like the dirty one?
I don't.
You do, I can't get away.
You're locals here, aren't you?
Yeah.
I don't know of any cottages to rent in the area, do you?
Cottages?
Yes, I heard there was one up at the big house. What's it called? Jared's?
No, there's nothing at Jared's.
Their chauffeur's got that. Mr. Garnet.
I can't think of any vacant cottage these parts.
So the, Jared's place is let permanently then to the chauffeur's family?
Well, there's only him and his daughter, Jessica. Nice little thing, isn't she, Stan?
The wife works up there. There's a bit of domestic. I'd rather she didn't, but she likes her independence, don't you, girl?
There's nothing to rent up there.
Can I get you both a drink?
No,
please. Oh. So it's Stan. And
Doreen.
How did you pay for it?
My mother's. I can't dispel her.
She'll be mad.
She doesn't know. And when she does, where will she find me?
It's brighter than a traffic light.
This respray is because you haven't been doing your job properly, little Joe. I'll need you to do better this time. All right.
Are we being followed?
I don't think so. Why do you ask?
We keep looking in the mirror with a grave expression.
The other day I thought we might have been, but I was mistaken.
It's easy to get neurotic, isn't it? My husband sees burglars and bag snatchers in every crowd. If his own mother called, he'd demand an ID. It's made me worse. Ralph is the very essence of caution. You could call it paranoia. He lives it. That's why I'm... He chose you out of 25 applicants. He has a whole team of private detectives vetting everyone.
He went to those lengths.
I shouldn't have told you. Are you angry?
It's not my place to be angry, is it?
What would you do if you were offered money to betray me?
What?
I said if you were offered money to betray me.
I don't understand.
You'll know when it happens.
Do you mind if I say something?
What?
I think your husband's paranoia is rubbing off. I mean, when was the last time there was even a burglary in the village?
I don't know if you've been told, but that switched their locks, all the windows and doors in one go.
Not every man's a thief or a rapist, Mrs. Absalom.
Please call me Nina. I hate to be called Mrs. I knew I'd have to tell you sometime.
Tell me what?
It's just that it's hard for me to talk about. I was kidnapped once. That's why I'm so nervous. You haven't answered my question about betraying me.
I'm just your driver. There's no question of that.
Going to an agricultural show on Saturday, and I need to visit Aubrey briefly. Why don't we take Jessica to the seaside for the afternoon?
I don't know. I'll have to ask her.
It'd be nice to spend some time with her. I don't know any children.
This is the best thing anybody ever gave me. I'm going to keep it forever.
It's only guaranteed for a year.
Hello. Just arrived. Oh, you're going to have a jolly good time, aren't you?
We'll eat in style tonight, somewhere smart. I'm sick of slumming it. When it was all over, the old man had a heart attack.
Was it the shock?
Strain would be a better word. The kidnappers held the princess for 3 weeks. When the prince stalled on the ransom demand, they sent him a whole fingernail with dried blood at the root of it. The younger Italian was a medical student. He got it from a corpse.
And all the time, she was chained up in a tent.
It was a very long chain. It didn't hurt.
Everything all right, sir?
Very good, thank you. She only saw the foreigner. They talked, the princess and he, talked for hours. He brought her meals, waited on her as though he were a servant. She slept a lot, worried about her husband, or said she did. The kidnapper sent Piranesi another tape and instructions about what he should do next. Very early Sunday morning, the old man was to bring 800 million lira, the sum they'd finally agreed on, to a church in Florence. The church was reached by a trail of clues, placed carefully along the route. He arrived at the church at 7:45 a.m., just after the doors had been opened.
Signora. Thanks.
Sapete che non è permesso fare fotografie con il flash in questa chiesa?
Sì, sì.
Devo controllare la vostra borsa.
No, vi assicuro.
Insisto. Aprite, prego. Devo sequestrare la vostra macchina.
When he came out, the beggar had gone. There was only a note telling him where to find the princess.
Where was she?
On a train heading for Rufina station.
I'd like to write to my sister. Do you think I could?
Relatives are a pain in the arse.
Not Tilly, she's different. She hates families. She's had three different ones. And she says she'll never have children.
Please yourself, Annie, don't go on. How can I get Garnet's telephone number?
Where were the princess's relatives?
In England.
They didn't know?
Nobody knew. Only the prince. The details were never revealed and the kidnappers never caught. That's the way it was then in Italy. The rich just paid up. They didn't want the publicity.
But, I mean, if it weren't in the papers or nothing and the prince didn't tell anybody, I mean... How do you know about it?
How do you think? I was the foreigner.
Christian name, Daddy?
I don't know. What are you doing out of bed?
Will you brush my hair, please?
Princess?
10 years ago when she was a top fashion model. At Aneso's funeral.
We've kept them all this time.
Now you know everything. So let's do it.
Who's your friend Richard, Daddy?
I haven't got a friend, Richard.
Yes, you have. He rang while I was at Debbie's house.
Richard?
He said, could he have a phone number?
You talked to him?
Dan did first, then me. He said he was your friend Richard, and could he have our phone number? So I gave it to him. Stan said I was clever to remember it.
How'd he get Stan and Doreen's number?
That's what Doreen said. Who is he, Dad?
I think he may be somebody I taught at school. I think I should have a solicitor here. Well, shouldn't I? Look, I know it seems stupid, sounds ridiculous, but I just wasn't taking it very seriously, that's all. Well, I would have, but I suppose I had other things on my mind.
Are you sick?
My grandma told me she should
have
this
for all
life. Daddy
was born somewhere too.
Was he? We have something in common then.
Too happy?
We are rather late, I'm afraid.
Likes his tea on the table, does he? I've been worried sick.
I'm sorry, darling, we were having fun.
Fun? See to it you collect the photographs and descriptions of the landscape gardeners before they arrive tomorrow. There's a good chap. Don't want any mishaps.
Thank you.
In you go, it's ready. Mr. Garnett?
Yes?
You don't know me. I'm in a position to offer you a large sum of money. You there?
What do you want?
The princess.
Princess?
Mrs. Absalend. We want Mrs. Absalend. £200,000, Mr. Garnett. Mr. Garnett.
What do I have to do for it?
Look the other way, that's all. When you drive her to Cambridge on Thursday...
Are you Richard?
You'll get the instruction later. I'll give you 15 minutes to think about it, all right?
He asked me if I was Richard.
What are you doing, Daddy?
Nothing, sweetheart, just doing this.
I'm getting out soon.
Dry yourself in the bedroom.
I don't know why I didn't call the police. I was afraid I'd lose everything, I suppose. My job, my home. But Absalom might take her away.
Yes? I gave you an extra 5 minutes just for good measure.
Who are you?
Have you thought about it?
Leave us alone.
I can hardly hear you. £200,000, Mr. Garnett.
The answer's no!
I heard.
Daddy! What if I could have offered him half the money straight away?
We haven't got it, have we? All we've got is a poxy credit card.
Shall I try again?
Have you got £100,000?
How are we going to do it then?
The only way now is by force.